Hello friends, today's topic is transformation principle and it is in the chapter molecular basis of inheritance. So which molecule is considered as the basis of inheritance? So we all know that molecular basis of inheritance is the DNA molecule. It is considered as a molecule which is the basis of inheritance. That means this is deoxyribonucleic acid, means DNA, and it is present inside the cell's nucleus, a structure or organelle which is known as nucleus, and which is in the cell membrane inside the cell. And whenever a cell wants to divide, it has to make copy of its DNA, that is genetic material, and then it will open up this double helical molecule to make two DNAs out of it, and then this double copy will be separated inside two cells. The nucleus will be separated inside two cells, and then this copy is been transferred into the daughter cells. So one cell give rise to two cells with the same genetic material or the DNA. This is the process. But when this was not known, when there was no such term as chromosomes were there, and there was no such term, or the people don't know that the DNA is a genetic material. At that time, few scientists did the experiments. The number one scientist who did the experiment was Frederick Griffith, and his experiment is known as transformation. This is known as its work was on Streptococcus pneumoniae bacteria. And this bacteria is known to cause the pneumonia, lung infection in humans. And it can cause to death if not treated properly. So what he did, he took two strains of this bacteria. One is R strain or rough strain. It makes rough colonies on the colonies on nutrient medium, and one is S or smooth strain, and it has capsule, so its appearance was it makes smooth colonies on the media while growing. So when he injected the live R strain in the mice, then the mice was living life because the mice was able to show immune response and was able to kill the R strain. But when live S was injected in the mice died due to pneumonia. So this S strain, we can say, is a pathogenic strain. So this is virulent, or we can say this is virulent strain, or this is pathogenic strain. And now if he injected mice with heat killed S strain in the mice, then the mice was living, as the property of the S strain was no more present, and the cell, the mice was living. Now the fourth, what he did was live R strain And he injected live aspirin with the heat killed aspirin. And to his wonder, when he injected the solution mixture into mice, the mice was dead. So, because of its observations, he proposed that a transforming principle, which states that something has release of transforming principle from heat killed aspirin that changed live R into live S, as from mice live S cells were found, were extracted. So it was some material which was released from the R strain, release of transforming principle from heat killed S strain, and that has changed the live R into S form, and this principle is known as transforming principle. It was given by Frederick Giffith and in 1928. So this was the first experiment, which was a proposal that the DNA can be a genetic material.